not abuse your freedom.
Galatians 5, verses 13 and 14. For you, brethren, have been called to liberty. Only, do not use liberty as an opportunity for the flesh, but through love serve one another. For all the law is fulfilled in one word, even in this: you shall love your neighbor as yourself. In Paul's epistle to the Galatians, he reminds us of our liberty which we have in Christ, and he encourages us to stand firm in the liberty with which Jesus has set us free, and not to be entangled again with the yoke of bondage, referring to the law and coming under all the observances of the law. But he goes on to tell us, you know, we've got freedom, but do not use your freedom to gratify your flesh. That means we are still people who walk, keeping our flesh under. We make sure that we do not do the things that are displeasing to God. And we do not do things that offend other people. He says, through love, serve one another. And he says, if you walk in love, you know, we are fulfilling all the requirements of the law. We are not in bondage to the law, but we are fulfilling all of that and more when we walk in love. And he continues on in that same chapter to tell us that when we walk in the Spirit, there is no law against that. We bear the fruit of the Spirit of love and joy and peace and kindness, meekness, temperance, faith. There's no law against these things. There's complete freedom when we walk in the Spirit. So the point here is this: Jesus has set us free from being in bondage to rules and regulations and man-made things and religious systems that will be a burden on us. He set us free from all of that. And yet, there is the responsibility not to use our freedom to satisfy the things of the flesh. The freedom we have is to walk in the Spirit and to bear the fruit of the Spirit in our lives. And the love of God, we bless people around us. So remember, the freedom we have is to help us become more like Jesus. It's not a license to gratify the things of the flesh. Do not use your liberty, he says, as an opportunity for the flesh, but by love, serve one another and walk in the Spirit, and you will not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you for the liberty and the freedom that we have in Jesus. But we pray that by the empowering of your Spirit, we'll use our freedom to walk in love, to bear the fruit of the Spirit, and to bless lives around us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.